Well, here in Maine, we're used to changing seasons and changing weather, but how much the weather has changed on a large scale is the topic of a hotly debated issue across the globe. WMTW News 8 meteorologist Mallory Brook recently attended a conference on climate change at Bentley University and helps us to separate fact from fiction.
This conference was targeted at broadcast meteorologists and how we can clear up some of the misconceptions about what's been happening on and above the Earth's surface.
So we took to the streets and to Facebook to see what you believed about climate change, and I'll let you know whether that's fact or fiction.
Greg Barker of Lewiston writes, "While the climate is changing, I believe it is due to natural fluctuations in the sun's energy output. That would be fiction. The latest studies found 97% of scientists believe changes are occurring due to human causes."
If we try to separate all those natural factors, the climate change factors that happen over millions of years, those are very different timescales than what we're seeing now. Over the last 100 years or so, we've increased about 1.5 degrees Fahrenheit, and of all those factors that go into it, only a small fraction can be attributed to natural things like the amount of energy coming out of the sun.
Paul Harrison of Brunswick says he's noticed the extremes.
The evidence is all around us. You know, warmer falls, more severe weather changes, drastic floods, drastic droughts.
That is a fact.
We can't link any of those individual weather events to climate change. However, what we can see is that over time, we'll expect an increased frequency of those events. This is something we can see on the climate scale. We can actually see the increased precipitation. We can see the increased frequency and probably severity of these storms as well.
Steve Hall of Wyndon wrote via Facebook, "Some winters were warmer and some had snow. You really need to look back at history. Take last winter. It was cold right into April." That's fiction. One season doesn't change much in the grand scheme of climate.
Weather, of course, are the short-term atmospheric conditions, whereas climate is averaged out over usually decades. And so it takes a long time for us to see some of these patterns emerging out of a single season.
Nancy DeCesare of Brunswick says she's noticed a change in wildlife.
In the summers, they're getting hotter. And the animals, I'm from Cape Cod, and the animals such as the sea turtles are getting confused, as well as the seals.
Several people mentioned our changing ecosystems on Facebook too, and it's fact.
When we get a little bit more cold, we put on a jacket. When we get too warm, we take it off. Ecosystems are a lot more finely tuned, so they have very narrow ranges of tolerances and things like temperature. What we've seen is an explosion, for example, in the reported number of Lyme disease cases. Maine and New Hampshire are among the top three in new reports of cases since 1990. And the reason for that is because the ticks are moving now up elevation. They are going to stay in areas where it's warmer for longer.
Szymanski also notes northern New England has actually warmed slightly more than the national average of 1.5 degrees, up about 2 degrees in the last 100 years. Reporting for News 8, I'm meteorologist Mallory Brooks.